You're next in line for the official Holiday World podcast.
Welcome to Holiday World in Splash and Safari.
Dropping in from Santa Claus, Indiana.
Riders will experience swift acceleration, high-speed turns, and sudden stops.
With park president and CEO, Matt Eckert.
Other things randomly drop off of my calendar, but this never does.
Vice president and COO, Matt Bloomhart.
Geese are like the worst.
Media relations manager,
Sabrina Jones.
Oh boy, hot take.
Director of entertainment and events and fourth generation owner,
Lauren Crosby.
I do what I can. It's a podcast.
And director of communications and fourth generation owner,
Leah Cook Bloomhart.
I do a terrible job as a podcast host. Someone should fire me.
Now stow your loose articles, buckle up,
and please keep your hands and legs inside the car at all times.
And we're back. Welcome back to Season 5 of the official Holiday World podcast. This is Season 5, Episode 9, the one with the best visit ever. Today is Tuesday, May 2nd for us, but we plan to release this episode Monday, May 22nd. Welcome back, Lauren.
Hello.
Matt B.
Good to be here.
Matt E.
Greetings.
And Sabrina.
Hello.
You guys are really on it today with the responses. All right. So I would say, once again, what do you do in the off season? But we're in it now. Mm-hmm. We're going.
And we're busy.
We
absolutely are busy. So busy that we're going ahead and anticipating that we're going to be busy and recording an extra episode early this time around. So rather than do our full format today, what we're going to do is give you a little bit of our best advice for tips for the best visit ever.
I just want to say I had a big victory.
Yes.
So before the episode started,
yeah,
we were talking about phone cases.
Yeah.
Sabrina commented that my phone, sorry, you said you wanted content for another episode.
Yep.
And my phone currently doesn't have a case.
It's naked.
It's a naked phone.
He's
right
just
now.
Out here living reckless.
And so Lauren was kind enough to recommend a phone case on Amazon. And I just realized I have enough points to pay for the whole thing.
Hey.
So I'm ordering it right now.
It's for free.
So this Thursday, I'll have a phone case again.
Hey.
So thank you, Lauren.
Well,
thank you, Sabrina.
My pleasure.
So it's free. Anyway.
That's
kind of like our soft drinks parking. And
yes.
There you go.
There you go.
Okay.
Which helps to make the best visit ever.
It does. Okay, we're done.
You know what? I'm going to segue that into a piece of advice, and that is definitely bring your phone. Keep your phone with a nice charge on it. And put a case on your phone. Do not bring your phone on a ride.
Correct.
Unless you want to part with it early.
Because that will ruin your
That's
day.
That's going to ruin everybody's mm-hmm. day.
Or like someone behind you.
Yes.
Day.
Yes.
Everyone's day.
Yep. Please don't try to take photography. We have, Steven mm-hmm. has beautiful on-ride footage. We've had professional teams come on site.
Mm-hmm.
We have excellent footage. No one wants to see
We're happy to share
cell phone
all
footage.
Of the footage.
No.
Yep.
No one wants to see that.
Nobody wants it.
No
and
one.
And if you do, we will find you on YouTube and we will report it.
Yes, we do.
Yes, we also do that.
Someplace more brutal with that.
Liam Neeson.
Glad you just left it to report it.
We have a very particular set of skills.
Your tone was very menacing.
If we do see you violating the loose articles policy,
banned.
We can't eject you from the park.
And
we take
rider
misconduct very seriously.
We're our office is right by the Voyage, and frequently people stop the ride if they see it on
We take rider safety very seriously, so don't have your phone out.
Yes. Yep. And if you happen to lose your phone on an attraction and you can see it on Find My iPhone, let a staff member know.
Yes.
Do not try to retrieve it yourself. We will help you get that.
Mm-hmm.
All right. That started really intense. I feel like...
Sounded like we were scolding our listeners before we...
Really sorry about that, guys. You're actually really friendly. if somebody really has never been here before, of course, we're known for free soft drinks, free parking, and free sunscreen. So you can feel free to pack pretty light. You don't need to bring sunscreen with you. You don't need to pack a giant bottle of water or something with you. That's all going to be in the park.
And there's no catch.
For free.
It's really free. Like, you don't have to buy a special cup.
Nope.
You can. We have great souvenir
wristbands.
Cups.
Yep.
But it's not like so many per hour. Like, there is no catch.
But a good piece of advice, we do offer free sunscreen, so use it.
Like, yes.
Nothing will ruin your day more than taking small children home with sunburn. Mm-hmm.
Crispy babies.
Do not do that. Like,
don't
that's
do it.
Why we provide it, so that you can make sure that you keep your family safe.
Yep.
Yes,
and
please
apply that early.
Yes,
and often.
And often.
And let it soak in before you get into the water.
For everybody's sake, because that also affects water quality at some of our older attractions. Looking at you, the wave.
Yeah.
And if the water quality is too bad, we have to shut the attraction down for a while until we get the water quality where we need it to be.
So that makes everybody mad.
Big
sad face.
There we are back at scolding again.
Bring it in, guys.
Some energy right now. All right. Who else has some piece of advice?
I think one of my favorite things as a mama is now my kids are old enough that they have, my mom started this when we were early pass holders, like when our kids were small. They have Holiday World bags and they're responsible. It holds their towel. We have curly hair, so it has a little bottle of spray conditioner, like swim stuff. Like, I mean, she's got it going on and it keeps their season pass in it. And so like they are responsible and it's like the best system. When I get in the car, like we just load them up and they go in a bag. And then when they get there, it's their responsibility. So it's got their towel and their stuff in it.
I love that. That's a great idea.
Yeah.
I know this is a me thing. It's probably a Lauren thing too, but I'm a planner. So like go to our website before you come to the park and like try to plan out your day. Like I think that will make your day go so much better if you can kind of have a vision of the things that you want to do, when you want to do them. We have lots of information on our website. Mm-hmm. So check it out.
If you see one of our brochures around, it has a park map on it and it has a little fold out that says, have to ride. Steven, can you help me out on what the...
It's either want to ride it or rode it.
Want to ride or rode it. Yep. Yeah. So you can use that to plan your trip and take it with you.
Yeah. I was going to say, as a planner, what I miss whenever I go to some other parks, I love that our website, like you can go to every restaurant and it will tell you every food item that is at that restaurant. So if you know that like you're kid has to have chicken tenders and your other kid has to have a cheeseburger, so we have to find somewhere that has both, I can go ahead and look through all the menus and say, okay, this restaurant, I can figure out how many of them have that and figure out where they are, and then I can be like, you know, make a mental note, we need to be in these places, like one of these places by this time, so we can
helps you prevent any potential meltdowns.
So then you're not wandering the park, walking up to the window, looking at the menus. Oh, well, we can't eat that food.
Yeah.
You know, like
in the hot sun.
Yeah.
When everyone's with cranky hungry kids. And thirsty and cranky.
Although I will say that for those that wish to be a little more free spirited,
and not so. What are you saying about me and Lauren?
So scheduled down to the minute. If you go to Santa's Mary Marketplace, that pretty much has anything that you would want for anybody. Like you can make almost everybody happy.
Yeah,
that's very true.
Steven's very familiar with the menus because he has the great pleasure of putting them all on the website, right? And making all the menus for that matter.
Digital menus, yes.
He probably knows the menus better than I do, and I help with the pricing. So.
Well, I was just going to advise too that if you have any allergens or if you just want to eat on the healthier side, we also have special menus called out that Steven has made beautiful for you.
Yes, we have special buttons at the top of our food and snacks page. So holidayworld.com/food. And it will have our allergens. It has a healthier options menu. And we have a dedicated gluten-free menu. Again, if you're free-spirited, just go to George's because everything there is safe. Yes.
And by the way, we have an entirely gluten-free crouton. And we have an entirely gluten-free stand. George's gluten-free. They have pizza, pretzels, funnel cake. I still don't know if I've heard of another park that has a gluten-free funnel cake.
Well, it's because we came up with the recipe.
Yep.
And it's made in Georgia's, so there's no
contamination.
I mean, that cauliflower pizza is so good.
It is good.
It is, and I feel like it has a good sauce on it. Like, it's very good. Yep. Big fan.
All right. What are some other tips?
Okay, so because you didn't lose your phone on a ride because you stowed it in the loose article.
Correct.
Button, and you have your phone with you. Sorry.
And we're not shouting at you because you didn't do that. Because
you did follow the rules.
We're not scolding because you followed the rules.
Only
good
because.
Good job.
Two thumbs up. If you hop on our park Wi-Fi or if you just go to holidayworld.com/today, if you hop on the park Wi-Fi, you should be automatically redirected to this page as well. And it gives you the park hours for the day. Mm-hmm. It gives you the show schedule for the day. A lot of times people are like, oh man, I missed this show. Well, you can see that. You can even add it to your iPhone calendar or your Android calendar, like right from there, so that you can get a notification when the show is going to start, all that kind of stuff. it has links to our menus. It's got, you know, all this stuff. So it's got a lot of really good information. We're not going to have you tied down to the phone where you have to look at it every second of the day.
No.
But it's there to help you kind of make quick decisions on, hey, what's the next thing we're going to do, or what do we want to watch? You know, what show do we want to go to? All those kind of things. So make sure that you visit that, because it's a great resource for those people in the park.
And that page also has a little crawler across the top that will normally link to what rides are down, or if there's any sort of information you need to know about the day, we'll include that link there as well. And it has our daily deals. And our daily deals are, I think, a very cool promotion where it's basically just whatever day of the week we have a deal for that. So I think we've got like Dole Whip Wednesday is kind of a,
it's a favorite.
Has been around for a while. So I encourage everyone to check that out, because there are special deals just depending on what day of the week you come.
And you don't even have to ask for them. It just happens.
Yeah. It just happens. There's no secret code.
No promo code. It just happens.
Yep. I think another goldmine page, if you're planning, is the FAQ page that we have on our website, and then also the
services.
Thank you. Rules and services with answering social media questions over the years. I like have that page is just, it's a big, I mean, it's a long page, but it really covers everything that you could need to know really about what's in the park.
In terms of attractions, avoid things in the front in the morning. So like the Raven has its longest waits of the day as the park opens.
And typically the most popular rides, stay away from them in the beginning.
Stay away from the Raven specifically.
Yes.
And possibly the Legend, and come and do those later.
Plus, it helps you get, then you don't have to walk up the hill.
Start at the back. Yeah, if you can start at the back of the park.
It's the cheater way up the hill.
Thunderbird and Voyage are good options.
Yeah.
Yep. Walk, don't run.
Yes.
I was actually going to say on the other end of that spectrum.
Walk, please.
But head to Hall of Dogs Funtown.
Yeah, not
at the
ranch.
Beginning of the day with your kids.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hot tip. Yeah.
That's a good tip.
Like, there's a handful of rides back there for your little ones to ride, and you can ride them with them.
Yes.
There's a water splash pad, a playground. I mean, it's a kid gold mine.
It really is.
And there's even a restaurant. So if you guys just want to hang out there for hours on end, there's food.
I like that restaurant.
And there's a special, restrooms and a dedicated soft drink dispenser there. So
yes.
With lemonade and Gatorade and water for
that's, I guess, in general, I was just going to say, head to Funtown earlier in the day, because, as the day goes on, it gets busier.
Yep.
Those corn dogs there are bussing.
And then
really?
I had to use it.
The only attractions that I would tell everyone to try and hit first thing would be the water coasters.
Yep. You stole one of my pieces of advice.
Sorry. Continue.
Nope, that was it.
Those lines kind of build up pretty quickly, and they stick around for most of the day. So
I feel like, too, if you can swing it to make it a weekend where you do one park one day or half of, you know, like you can do it all in one day, but to really get, I feel like, the most out of each park, it's more enjoyable. Like, you're not rushing through it. Like, when we come to the park, we pick, is it a dry park day or a water park day?
Yep. If you have it in your budget, consider a cabana or a Cheetah Chase Lounger. It's an option a lot of people like. We charge different prices based on different days. It's based on demand. They're very high demand, but if you're looking for a day where it's a little more reasonable, we have a calendar on the website.
Yep.
As usual, we are very transparent, as we are with the food pricing. You can see different prices for different days.
I was going to add to that pick your day wisely. If you come on a Saturday in July, especially in late July, there are going to be big crowds. You're going to be waiting in a lot of lines. If you come on a Tuesday in June, you're probably going to have, especially if it's a little bit rainy or overcast, you're going to have a great day. You might not even need a second day, depending on if you hit everything or not. But yeah, you're going to have very short waits.
And those cabanas now, you can order straight to it, which I feel like that's an amazing, you're not in the line.
The cabanas now have a mobile order
capability. Function.
Yeah. Oh, man. That's going to be great.
And Leah, you touched on something too. Like, if it looks like it's going to be overcast, don't let that deter you from coming.
Let it encourage you.
Encourages you to come. We do have a worry-free weather guarantee now that, you know, if we have to shut the rides down for whatever reason, due to weather, we will give you a ticket to come back another day if it's shut down for a certain period of time. So do not let weather forecasts scare you. What I found is, and I love you, weathermen, you tend to be a little bit more pessimistic and optimistic with your forecast because you need to make sure you cover all your bases, which I get. But, you know, just because they say there's a 40% chance of rain, that means there's a 60% chance that it won't. So, yeah.
And that doesn't actually mean what you think it means.
And it doesn't always happen in Indiana.
A 50% chance of rain does not mean that there, you know, that you have, you know, a coin toss chance of it's going to rain or not. That means 50% of a certain area is going to see rain.
Right.
That is very different from like, oh, toss a coin and it might rain.
And it could be for a very short period of time, too.
We don't know what that region is. We don't know what hours. We don't know.
And a lot of times, like, we call
it... And we operate still in rain.
Well, sorry, a lot of times we call it the hollow bubble.
Yes.
But, weirdly enough, where we are positioned...
The Santa Claus snow globe.
A lot of rain and storms happens to just break down around us.
I think it's because of Christmas Lake.
Yes. I would agree
there is,
with that.
I mean, there is a lake effect with snow and different things. There could be a little baby lake effect.
We had that at Cedar Point. We were surrounded by water and... Yeah. You'd have storm cells approaching, and it would just literally go around the park, like it'd split up.
Yeah.
And so. I feel like to piggyback off of our worry-free weather guarantee is to, when you come in, and if you have a physical ticket, take a picture of that.
Yes.
That way, if you get in the water park and your bag gets soaked if it gets wet somewhere or you put it in your pocket and it gets destroyed, you'll have a copy of that, and that will count for your worry-free weather guarantee. And also... This year with being cashless, take a picture of your receipt. If you give your kid a card with like $25 on it and they lose it, then you can call the number on that and get some of that money back.
You can also have that receipt texted to you, so it's even easier. But if you don't want to give up your phone number, we understand. And that's just for the cash-to-card kiosks. If you're paying with a credit card, you do not need to worry about those cash-to-card kiosks.
Yes, and there's a ton of ways to pay.
Yes.
Just because we're cashless, we are... making it very easy. You know, we've got, honestly, with me, with working social media, I'll have my phone. I mean, well, as I come as a guest too, you can pay with your phone, like the tap to pay or, you know, my debit card stays on my phone and it's very easy.
I wanted to go back to a hot tip for the Cheetah Chase loungers this year. There's a really cool new addition to the Cheetah Chase loungers in it's kind of like a personal locker. but it's more than a locker. It actually has like a cooler that you could put drinks in, keep them cold. It's got,
they're so cool.
I know they're awesome. It has cup holders on the top so you can use it like a table.
Oh, it's got a little charging
and it has
cables,
a charging port in the locker itself. So you can, so like you could,
Sabrina's renting hers right now.
Yeah,
right?
The loungers got really cool.
Take your phone in the water anyway, so you can lock it in the locker and charge it at the same time.
Unless you get one of those
really
cool bags.
Speak for yourself. My phone is very
waterproof. Oh, I forgot. You can do those bags like in the wave pool.
The beach
side. I got one of those and like wore it in like the kiddie area in a wave pool on a recent trip I went to that was not Holiday World. But it was awesome because I could have my phone with me and like it even like it still worked and I could take pictures. Like so.
Yeah, I know. My wife has one of those and I completely forgot. And we have those in the gift shops.
We do.
If you're traveling with a family or you're a season pass holder, consider a digital photo pass.
Oh, you took mine. You took mine. I'm such a proponent of the digital photo pass. This thing. If we're going to Disney or something like that, we always get the Memory Maker package thing and all that because it's such a cool thing. And we have a very similar system here and it works so well. We have not had any problems with it. And what's awesome is that some of the kiosks, like in the water park, are self-serve. And so, like, and you can do it, you can add it by your phone number. And so, like, our kids can actually get in there, and even if they don't have the physical card on them because they're in the water park or whatever, like, they can still add their pictures just by adding it to the phone number and stuff like that. And so it's such an awesome thing, and it's so cool to check it and then see the kids' pictures roll in and stuff. It's like, even if we weren't with them because they were off on their own, it's like we still get to be a part of their day, and we love seeing those pictures.
Steven's a big digital photo pass.
I know.
I'm a huge
proponent
of that digital photo pass.
Steven
is part
of a family of seven here. So.
Yeah, and it's really honestly the first purchase that we make in the park.
And with a family of seven, how many photo passes did you have to purchase?
So we only purchased purchased one, and we got and we got two cards. And so usually what happens is that my wife carries one and then either gives it to the kids if they want to go off on their own, or gives it to me. And as we split up and do different things, we can scan it. Mm-hmm. Or like I said, at some of the self-serve kiosks, the kids can just type in our phone number and it just adds it to the account. And it's so easy. Oh, mm-hmm. my gosh. And it's not just rides. We have photo spots.
Stations, yep.
We've got some selfie stations. Santa is included in that. Yep. Like, yep. It's so awesome. Like, I absolutely love it.
And compared to other parks, just saying. The price is quite affordable.
For an all season, it's $34.99.
You can't beat it.
I mean, and for an all day, $24.99. So, but if you figure how many pictures, you know how many pictures you took last year or have from it? I mean, is it hundreds?
It's in the hundreds. And it's triple digits
paid
at least.
$34.99. Yeah. I mean, it's you do the math.
Yeah.
One print photo is $14.99. So it just makes sense.
Well, if you do the all season digital photo pass, you get
discounts
on
the printed photos. Yeah.
Get $5 prints.
Ooh. Yep.
Yeah.
Along the same lines, I was going to call out the games playbook.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So if you are a games playing family, that might help you kind of stay on budget. If you're a person who maybe spends a lot, or maybe you get one for everyone in the family. Do you remember the price is not coming to me?
$20 for $25 worth of games dollars. Mm-hmm. And there's also
makes your game spend go farther.
There's other things in the book, like there's a couple of single use quick access passes. Mm-hmm. So there's some other goodies in there.
Absolutely.
It's a good value.
Mm-hmm. I think something that sets us separate from other parks, too, is that we don't have, like, stroller restrictions. You can bring your preferred stroller, wagon. Mm-hmm. I feel like there's a million different ways. One thing I will say is make sure the choice – we switched back to our stroller from our wagon because it was not fun to pull the wagon up the hill. Mm. At the end of the day, it's much easier to push something. Okay.
We have hills.
Yes, we do.
There are a lot of hills.
So think about that whenever you're trying to decide.
And you're packing.
At the beginning of the day, like, you know, maybe you have a 5-year-old and maybe you're like, oh, we don't need the stroller.
Yeah.
Maybe you do.
Yep. And also speaking of the hills, if you have a family member who maybe has some mobility issues or just, I mean, you know, family members, somebody has a bad knee, something like that. If they struggle with hills, I would definitely consider renting an electric scooter. Those are first come, first serve when you enter the park. I've got some hot tips on if it's a hot day. You definitely want to make sure you hit water.
Stay hydrated.
And some Gatorade, but mostly water.
Yes.
One of the things you can do also near the front of the park, for your little ones, there's a lot of things for them to explore, but we have little phone find wristbands that you can write your phone number on, and if they happen to get separated, just make sure that the little guys and girls know to come up to a Holiday World team member, and we can call the number and help you you all get reunited. So that's a neat thing to be able to do.
We had the conversation when the girls were little of, like, we'd point out, like, what their uniforms looked like. We're like, ooh, see that friendly person over there? Like, they're in, like, and we'd explain the colors and, like, that this is your favorite color. Like, and they're your friend and they'll help you. And then we also took a picture of our kid so that when security, if they asked.
Oh, that's a great
and they
idea.
Were like, oh. Hey, what were they wearing? Because I'm like, oh, my gosh, what were they wearing? Like, was that yesterday? Was that the day? Was it a purple? Like, or was it maroon? Like. Your memory isn't great in those situations. So if you just, we just made it a fun thing. And we would also take the picture by our parking mark because you know,
oh, look at you hacking that experience. Wow.
Two birds, one stone.
Hey, when your kids are little, you're in survival mode. Literally just try to keep them all alive. Yep. But yeah, I would take a picture of that because also at the end of the day, your cars all look the same. Like, it was a silver car. Like,
just keep walking.
Right, that silver van. There's so many.
Yep. I was also going to dive into the time that you eat. Think about it ahead of time. So maybe have a nice light snack before you go into the park. Or you can eat, I would say, up till 11:30. You can kind of get your pick of where you want to eat. Then things get really busy.
And that's central time.
That's
so
central time. Yep.
Eastern time.
Yep. Yeah.
Then like
still prime living time.
And if you're not on Verizon, has a very strong tower right on site. If you're not on Verizon, I would recommend that you put your phone in manual mode and set it to central time for the day.
Yeah.
Because different networks may pick up different towers. Mm-hmm. So since we have a really good Verizon tower, we tend to stay on central time now. but we used to flip around back and forth a lot on our time zones. So
we really like to plan our snacks around the shows using mm-hmm. that today page because yep. our kids are huge fans of the shows. Mm-hmm. And so they love to, we'll get some Dole Whip or a pretzel or something and hang out there. It's a wonderful place, that shade that we talked about in the last episode. It's a great place to just give little people a break. Mm-hmm. And
older yeah. people like us.
Yeah, I mean, fair.
And yeah.
You're fair. Doing it for yourself.
I, too, need a break and love pretzels.
If
so.
You're catching a show, yeah, at Hoosier Theater, then Sweet Stuff is right there. Mm-hmm. But then not very far is also
Freedom Funnel Cakes.
Mm-hmm. It's yep. a beautiful blue building now.
Yes. Yeah.
And Ben's Pretzels has a cart right there yes. around the corner.
It is perfect yes. for snacking.
And Lemon Shake Ups.
Lemon Shake Ups.
Yes. Yep. Which has yeah. nachos
it's
now.
It's really like the...
It's like a snacker paradise right, right there. Right?
It really is like the snack square.
Pro
right
tip, if your family
theater.
Can separate, go separate Ooh, and go yeah. to different locations. Divide. Get everybody's order.
And then bring it all back together. And
another share. Pro tip, Lemon Shake Up. If you're a person like me who really likes a high acid drink, very tart lemon shake up.
Just straight lemon.
Ask them to cut back on the sugar when they do that.
Or be like me and ask for extra sugar. Yeah.
Do you really ask for extra
Sometimes.
Sugar?
I get it just the way it comes.
But it's Splenda, so it doesn't even count.
It makes it sweeter.
It's fine, yeah. And it's
you want it to be tart. No, no.
Not
You're
that
incorrect.
Tart.
I no. would like to rot my teeth out, thank you.
My teeth will fall out of my head one day. Between the very sour lemons, the coffee, the tea. Yeah. It's fine.
Who needs teeth?
Anyway.
You can buy new ones.
Yeah,
it's fine.
Ones. You can yeah. get false ones.
Yep. Another piece of advice I have is, I think we touched on this a little bit, but you don't just have to use our souvenir cups for free soft mm-hmm. drinks. You can bring a reusable water bottle. We're not going to say anything, although I would advise that if you're like doing something vacuum sealed, that soda's not going to go well in there.
Yes. Yeah.
So that's a good one for lemonades, waters, Gatorades.
What happens? What happens to soda and something like that?
It tries to get out.
Yeah,
yeah.
yeah. So like when you go to open it, it may explode
like
a little
that
bit.
Will splash you in.
Builds
the
a lot of pressure.
Yeah. yeah.
Okay.
The Contigo
well,
cups.
Just yep. don't do yep. it.
Won't yeah. do that.
Yep.
We like to into like I like Leah's recipe. Is it like lemonade with water? It's a good
just like mostly water and just like a little splash of lemonade.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Just adds like it's like you dripped a little lemon in your water. Pro tip.
It's like make your own LaCroix.
It's like magic.
Yep. Yes.
Yep. All right, Holidays in the Sky starts June 17th.
Yeah, get to the Party Plaza like when we open yeah. it or like right like shortly after we open it. I'm trying to like think of times. Whatever time Holidays in the Sky is for that evening, the dance party will start, I believe, about 30 minutes before. The show hasn't actually been created. The DJ dance party has yeah. not actually been created gotcha. Yet. So,
because it's fresh.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. It will be created soon.
It's on the docket.
But so, yes, that I think that starts about 30 minutes beforehand. But there should be some pre-show music happening about 15 minutes before that. And we normally open the plaza about an hour before the show. Mm-hmm. So you'll only be down there for about 15 minutes without like actual entertainment happening.
Right.
So you might as well get down there, stake out your spot, yep. mm-hmm. Get ready.
Stop and then, at the candy cornucopia before that, really stock yeah. up on the sugar.
There you go.
Or Ben's Pretzels.
Or dinner at Plymouth Rock Cafe.
Yeah, you can get it to
or
go.
Or Dippin' Dots. Mm-hmm.
You can get your Thanksgiving meal to go from Plymouth Rock and bring it down to the plaza.
True.
Yep.
Well, we also have snacks and an oasis down there as well.
Yes.
Right. So, and like, wonderful. Even if you forget,
yes,
we've got stuff down in the
party.
Yeah,
yeah, we're making
too.
It sound like it's a desert.
Oh, no, it's not. And there's a,
we're just trying to advise, like, the
you walk 7 miles with no shoes on your feet.
Ooh, bug spray but, at that time. I mean,
oh, yeah.
I found natural, like, stickers that you stick on. Oh. And I would say for like the time that you're going to be in the plaza, they work fine. Outside of that, maybe not.
So it's not actually, it's a sticker?
It's just like stickers and you stick them on like for adults, they recommend 2 stickers on you. So I put like one up on my shoulder or something. And
I've
one
never heard of that.
I haven't either.
On That's my clever. Shorts or whatever. And like, does it do a perfect job? No. But is it way better than coating myself in bug spray? Yes. Yes, it is.
You can find them on Amazon.
Yes.
I mean,
you can find everything on Amazon.
Oh, yep. Yeah, you can.
I yep. love Amazon.
Yeah, you can also buy some light-up toys down in the plaza. They're also available elsewhere in the park.
Yes.
But there are also some down in the plaza. So
our merchandise team has some great options. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's really cool, too, when it gets dark, like seeing all these toys lighting up, and kids love them. And it's just,
absolutely.
It's really
I would
cool.
recommend if you have a set souvenir budget to save a little bit for the end of the day, because kids and those light up toys, it's hard to say no.
The German American Bank Plaza is,
yes,
it's popping down there with snacks and lights. Yep. And
anybody who's been to Disney on Ice knows.
Oh my gosh, yes. No one
what kind of options
me.
You have for saying no to a light up toy at the end of the day.
but back to the tips of Holidays in the Sky. Come and go to see Holidays in the Sky.
Absolutely. Oh, yes.
It is completely an experience.
Yes. Like, well, if you notice, we just discussed it like it was non-optional.
Right.
Sorry.
Right. But I've talked to a lot of people who start seeing people go down there and like, we're going to go ahead and leave. We're going to get out of the park. Okay, great, but you just missed probably the best thing
one
of the entire
coolest
day.
Right. Yes.
And I was a skeptic last year. I didn't think it was going to be as popular as it was, and I was completely wrong. Yes. It was fantastic.
I would add to that that you can see it from other places in the park, but
you can't experience it.
I would argue that the best place to watch it is in the party park.
100%.
Yeah. So,
because you get like, it's a sensory thing too. Mm-hmm. Like you get all the sounds and
that's where you can get the closest to it. So like you're like, whoa.
Yes. Right. It really shows how big it is.
Yes.
The displays
and you can
are.
See it on, you know, you can see it on the computer. You can see it on YouTube. You can see all those pictures. Well, it's not
it's
the same.
Yeah. And like, just put your phone away.
Yeah,
and like pull it out and try to take like a picture, but don't try to film the whole thing. It's just not going to turn
gonna
out.
Miss out.
We've got a lot of talented photographers and videographers, including our own team, that are out taking photos and videos. Use those.
It's difficult to capture.
It's so difficult to capture.
So just be in the moment.
It's not a regular drone show.
Or, you know, it's snap really a quick pic of your kid without using a flash.
Yes.
Please don't turn
them with their light up toy.
Yes.
I would also advise that the elevated experience is a very cool thing, and it's going to be even cooler this year. So we're going to have a dessert party vibe going on.
Nice.
The elevated experience with desserts and all kinds of treats.
I will say that area, you talked about leaving. For us, it's like we'll kind of scale back. We'll do nap, and then we'll go to the park. On the glorious days, we still get a nap in. It's those days are getting less and less.
Yeah. Lauren's like, what's that?
Right.
I know.
Never heard of her.
My 3-year-old is done with naps.
Oh, sad day.
Done.
But we'll try to do like a nap, and then we'll come in. But it's totally worth it to stay to the very end. Those bathrooms are amazing there. Mm-hmm.
They're great bathrooms.
They're great bathrooms. Quality. Yes. We even went as far. My sister, they live farther.
You tell your parents.
Right.
Those are great bathrooms.
Quality family-sized bathrooms.
I follow an Instagram account that's just about Walt Disney World bathrooms. Okay, so
what?
Yeah, it's very fun.
It sounds like it.
It's entertaining. Listen, they give you hot tips on like the best restrooms.
Hot tips on bathrooms.
But my sister, they live.
But listen, those are some good restrooms at Holiday World. But
they are. You're
down
right.
in the Party Plaza.
You're right.
Those are top notch.
It makes
restrooms.
Me want to go right now.
Right.
Wow.
Okay. But we'll even go anyway. My sister, they live about 2 hours away, and they'll go as far. Like we'll even like maybe even throw on PJs like there. That way, everyone gets to the car or the bathrooms in the Legend parking lot. Those are also sizable. Throw like we've been known to leave their street clothes on in the park, and then when we get to that, we'll throw on PJs. That way, if everyone falls asleep, you can just throw them in bed. They don't have their park clothes on. It's the next level, I'm pretty sure.
Wow. Those are some solid hacks you've got there.
If that's, because I mean,
so I felt like I was a planner. Sabrina's got me trumped, I think.
No, I just, survival, man. I feel like it's lazy parenting disguised as genius.
For you, though.
I know, I appreciate it.
It seems very strategic.
We love the park and we come a lot. So.
I also want to advise before we move on from Holidays in the Sky, just to check the showtime. The park is going to close before showtime on most nights. Holidays in the Sky
Except
is going.
For Saturdays.
Yep. Whenever you hear that the park is closed, that means most of the park is closed. Mm-hmm. That means it's your time to go down to the Thanksgiving section. Mm-hmm. Not that you need to get out of the park, and nobody should be trying to encourage you to leave the park. We had, I think, at least one person last year was very confused and upset about that. And I'm like, it was just, needed to go down the hill.
I think, too, get your Voyage rides in early. And is it Crow's Nest? Because Thanksgiving section, those hours vary on those nights. Because they need to, be checking things and getting things ready. So
that brings me to another tip, is just that our lines close before the park does. And that's just a function of we have a lot of high school students. And we have a lot of labor laws that we need to follow. So we need predictable hours that our team goes home every night. So we shut our lines down early on busy days when the lines are long. So plan ahead. If you want to be riding the voyage at the last second, you need to try and get in line early.
Yeah.
All right. I think we've pretty much exhausted the list.
Good job, guys.
One more thing.
If you don't want to come now, we don't know what's wrong.
Right? Yep.
Oh, yeah,
if you have a lousy day, it's not on us.
It's not our fault.
One more thing that I have on my list is that we have in-park ticket discounts. There's next-day tickets are $30. And there's also the option while you're in the park to upgrade your ticket for the day to a season pass. So don't miss out on those. If you're in the park and you decide that you have buyer's remorse because you didn't get a season pass, you can change it.
Yep.
At Holiday World and Splash and Safari, sometimes free takes a little convincing, especially with dads.
Free parking? That's how they get you.
They're just naturally suspicious of free stuff.
Free soft drinks!
Whoa, whoa, whoa. That's how they get you.
But after a day of fun on the world's longest water coasters and our 400 drone light show, dads come around. At Holiday World, we get you. We're just not out to get you. That's why there's
free soft drinks! Free parking! Free soft drinks!
Get tickets at holidayworld.com.
Take a summer job at Holiday World and Splash and Safari, and you might find yourself saying,
wait, I get paid for this?
Jobs at Holiday World are so much fun, it may seem ludicrous to get paid, but make no mistake, you do.
What about all the friends I'm making? Do I get paid for that?
Yes.
Launching coasters of screaming people?
Paid.
Working on my tan as a lifeguard? You can't tell me
you
I get
paid for that.
Whoa. So this job is, like, really cool. Does everyone know about it?
They will now. Put some fun in your funds with a summer job at Holiday World. Apply now at HolidayWorldJobs.com.
We're going to do a short, we are Holiday World and we love our holidays. All right. May 22nd is National Solitaire Day.
Solitaire Day?
Yeah. Like the card,
the card game. Yeah. I'm terrible at that game.
I'm pro solitaire on a computer, not in real life.
I can't play either.
It's difficult in real life.
I've never enjoyed the fireworks of solitaire. Can't say I've ever, I don't know that I've ever won a game.
Dang.
I love
solitaire. I feel like I probably cheated a few times to get there, but
yeah. There's like hints, I guess. Yeah. My mom's really good at solitaire. Yeah.
I like solitaire.
Solitaire. She blesses some of us and not others.
Right.
You can't be good at everything.
I also just really enjoyed that May 22nd is the start of Italian Beef Week, so.
Celebrate accordingly.
I mean, let's celebrate the fact that Portillo's is slowly getting closer and closer to us.
It's working.
God bless Italian beef. May 24th is National Escargot Day.
It's also my birthday.
Okay. Happy birthday, Aww. Matt.
Right. Yeah.
Isn't the 22nd, isn't that Eric's birthday?
And Andrew's.
Yep.
And
yep.
Andrew's.
They share a birthday.
Yep.
Absolutely.
Happy birthday.
We have a lot of May birthdays at
home. Ashley's is
oh my gosh,
the
yeah.
week before, isn't it? The 7th?
Yes, Six? And I feel like it's like pure chaos the entire like month, yeah. and so all of a sudden I look back and I'm like, how many birthdays did I miss? Oh my gosh,
it's
I'm
like
a
specifically
jerk.
Like the week my birthday is. There's like five or six birthdays that week.
Oh there's my a gosh, lot.
Yes. I just remember whenever we came back from COVID,
Paula's birthday was that week too.
Yeah,
we had like a little birthday party in Plymouth Rock Cafe for all the May birthdays.
Yep. Oh yes,
we did.
Yes.
And I just cleaned out my desk and I still had those birthday hats in there.
Nice. So anyway, National Escargot Day. Gonna celebrate that on your birthday?
I like escargot.
Yeah.
I don't have it ever, but I do like it.
Really really comes up here stateside.
I was going to say, that's not something they carry at the local grocery stores.
It's basically just a little garlicky, chewy thing.
Yeah.
It really doesn't have...
That pretty correctly describes it.
Yeah.
May 26th is National Road Trip Day.
Okay.
It's also National Paper Airplane Day.
Make a road trip to Holiday World.
Yeah, exactly. We'll be open daily at that point.
That'll be a Friday.
Yep. I was just going to ask on National Paper Airplane Day. Anybody good at that?
No.
Mm-mm.
Okay. I can make one, but they don't go very far.
Matt B, you kind of seemed like a person who might be really good at paper airplanes. You seem like a kid who tried it a lot.
A couple of times.
Different kinds.
You ever had one of those big foam airplanes?
Yes, I
like those when I was a kid.
Wow. Steven's throwing air.
That was quick. Like,
that was a pretty good one.
That's
a good
one, Steven.
Now that I've had a heart attack, thank you, Steven.
Literally throwing ourselves under the table.
Paper airplane.
See if I can.
Don't take out Lauren.
Right into my lap.
I'll go this way.
Nice.
All right. Not bad.
Very aerodynamic.
Wow, what a celebration.
We had.
Did we describe what just happened?
It's not until May 26, Stephen.
Stephen just produced from the tech booth a paper airplane directly across my lap, scaring me.
We went to a sporting event where you could buy a paper air. You bought a paper, and then you could make your own paper airplane. Mm. And I asked, could we roll it up into a ball and throw it? Because that's how you would win the promo. And it was Angela's breadsticks and pizza. And I was in it to win it. And they're like, no, you have to make a plane. And my kid handed it to me. And I don't think I've ever seen them more disappointed. I was like, I don't know how. Luckily, there was a family friend nearby that was like slightly disappointed, yet helpful in building one.
All right. May 27th is National Sunscreen Day. Nice. We love that. May 28th, had to call it out for Matt, National Brisket Day.
All right, I'll mark it on the calendar.
It's also National Hamburger Day and Indy 500 Day. Wow. So that's a big day. That's an outdoor kind of day right there. May 29th, of course, is Memorial Day and National Coke au Vin Day. Oh. Chicken and wine. All right. nailed it. May 30th is National Creativity Day. Don't forget to be creative that day.
Okay, because,
because nothing's better than on-demand creativity.
I'm creative. I'm not creative every other day of the year.
Yeah. Right? Yes. Exactly.
I never use creativity.
I was about to say, hug a creative day is what that should be.
May 31st is National Save Your Hearing Day.
Okay.
I'm looking missed at Matt that. B on that one.
Yeah, I missed that one.
Oh.
Well. Okay.
Okay.
Fair enough.
I don't know how many times I've given you the wrong AirPod for an interview. You're like, Sabrina, I don't need it. Yeah. Then we realized you did because it had a microphone in it.
Right.
So that was a lesson learned.
Fair.
What?
Matt Becker.
Huh?
Yep. Yep. That was a good one.
Repeat.
Lesson to learn.
Oh no.
All right.
Listeners, I'm deaf in one ear.
Yeah.
So there you go.
And now it sounds like we're just mean to you.
And that's okay. Be mean to the deaf guy.
Not fully.
Oh, jeez.
June 2nd is National Fish and Chip Day.
Okay.
Yes.
And National Donut Day.
Okay.
Love both of those.
And Rotisserie Chicken Day. Yeah. That's a good day, too.
It's a good day.
Interesting. Yeah. But I don't know that I'd eat all of them together.
I would say separate those out. Those are three different meals.
A good day to hit up a Costco.
Yeah, it is.
They have the best rotisserie chicken.
So many. Like, yes. How do you like the quality continuously all day?
Yeah.
Like, I have not had a bad rotisserie chicken there.
June 3rd, I had to call it out.
Don't.
Stop it.
It's National Black Beer Day.
Good thing we don't have those in Santa Claus.
We do not have those in Santa Claus. We're sorry if anyone was misled. It's also Insect Repellent Awareness Day. Coming back to our tips for holidays in the sky. Okay. That's when the books come out. Buy your patches, spray, whatever. June 4th is National Cheese Day.
Not to be put on apple pie.
That was last week's episode. Yep. But still, yeah, no.
Still don't do it.
Yep. Don't mix it with apple pie.
Still disgusting.
Just don't.
Yep. And June 4th, I always have to call it out. It's also National Hug Your Cat Day.
No.
I will go hug Kitty Claws.
Yeah, Kitty would love that.
Kitty Claws, I would say, is probably about the one extent of few safe cats to hug, yeah, I would guess.
That is the extent of my celebration.
I don't think any cat ever asked for that holiday.
No one wants it. Yeah. Especially the cat.
Fair enough.
Congratulations. You've tipped your way to the end of another episode. You can tell I didn't update this document. It's fine. Please join us in 2 weeks during your next commute cleaning session, etc. Or live at Hollywood Nights for our next episode, episode 10. The one where we're live from Hollywood Nights. It's coming.
It's happening. I'm crazy and they went with it.
Yep. I'm sure Stephen can't wait for that.
Editing session.
We can't wait because I'm sure we will have some Q&A. And I can't wait to tap dance around those.
Yeah, Alec, I think we were discussing it. He's like live? Like, yeah, live. Live.
Yep. We do it. You know what? I think most of us have done this at an enthusiast event of some sort. Yeah. So
they're harmless.
Yeah. We'll just keep talking about our fences. Am I right?
That's right. And grass.
And grass.
Fences and grass. Of course, thank you to our behind the scenes pod squad, Stephen and Alec, who were both the Stephen is currently
Stephen
face
can't breathe.
This one really fell off the rails at the end.
At the beginning, it's been off the rails the whole time.
The whole recording. Bless you, Stephen.
We had a pace going for a second. Of course. And thanks to all of you for continuing to listen and interact. If you're looking for ways to support Holiday World and Ho-Wo-Po, be sure to subscribe and tell all your theme park loving friends and rate us if you have that option. We want to hear your feedback and would love to hear our listeners' voices instead of ours, so call us at 812-937-4401, then dial 8081 to get Steven's long but informative instructions. If you're not able to attend Hollywood Nights and you want your question answered during our live session, we will play some of your submissions. So call ahead, put that in. Again, the number is 812-937-4401, then dial 8081. I'm nervous about that.
As you should be.
We reserve the right to not.
We're transparent here. What can I say? Of course, you can always share your feedback with us by emailing us at podcast@holidayworld.com or reach out to us on social media using the hashtag
#HoWoPo.
You've been listening to the official Holiday World podcast.
Welcome back. Did you enjoy your flight?
A production of Holiday World and Splash and Safari in Santa Claus, Indiana. Check out the latest episodes at holidayworld.com/podcast. Thanks for taking a ride with us.
And please come back to see us again soon.
You may have heard the kids chanting about favorite freebies at Holiday World and Splash and Safari.
Free soft drinks, free parking, free sunscreen!
But there are plenty of favorite firsts and onlys to shout about, too. Like soaring on America's only launched wing coaster.
Thunderbird!
The world's longest water coaster.
Mammoth!
In fact, we're the water coaster capital of
the world!
For summer fun worth shouting about, find your family's favorites with tickets at holidayworld.com.
Are you looking for a fun summer job with flexible schedules? We're hiring now at holidayworldjobs.com.